you know, when you step out on this field, everything else is gone. You know, it's about ball, and this is like my safe haven. You know, coming in between these white lines is what I do, and it's something that I love doing. So, you know, as soon as I step through these white lines, everything else in this world just, you know, goes blank, and I can just focus on what I do best and focus on my team around me and do whatever I got to do for them, you know, to help them succeed and help us succeed as a team.
With the information you've gotten, what's the range you're hearing might happen in the next 3 weeks, 3 weeks from now?
It's both. I mean, with my 40 time going down as much as it did, you know, it really helped out my stock. So, you know, I'm just going to go each and every week and just continue to these private workouts that I got going and the private workouts that I've already done and these visits I got to take, just show them who I am, you know, show them my knowledge of football and just, you know, it's just you got to be who you are. Ultimately, they're going to figure out if you're being fake or not, and you got to be who you are. So,
and in the end, it's just a matter of getting into a camp somewhere, right?
Right.
Right. You mentioned how your dad helped you out a lot. You guys were critique your game and do those sorts of things on the field. But what about off the field? How big has he been in helping you prepare for interviews and get the mental part of things right?
He's just been a good support system. I mean, he's been through it all. I mean, for 22 years, coaching, playing, he's been through everything. So, you know, nothing can get past him. Nothing phases him. So when something happened to me during this process, he just looked at it like when I didn't get invited to the combine, it was so unfortunate. It was somewhat a dream of mine. You know, I've always wanted to get invited to the combine. And when I got the phone call and they told me it was about politics and all this other stuff, he just told me, hey, listen, it's just another bump in your road. You know, it's just another little mountain you're going to have to get over. And it helped me because, I realized that. And then I got invited to my regional combine in Tampa. And I had a good day there. And I did what I had to do to get people's attention. So it was one of those things where he just helped me, you know, get over the little bumps in the road and just continue to encourage me as long with my family as well. And we just made through this process together. And we're going to keep going, keep fighting, and doing whatever I have to do.
You mentioned how he's been doing it for 20-something years. Yeah. Obviously, a lot of those come in Charlotte with the Panthers. That connection is so clear. Could you see yourself maybe being there? Have you had any conversations with them?
I mean, I've had a bunch of – I'm supposed to have a private with him in the next week or so, and I'm supposed to go up there for a physical. So, you know, just depending on, you know, what picks they have and if they'll be able to get me. But, you know, it's one of those things where, you know, somebody's going to get me early and the rest of the team's, you know, probably going to wish they got me.
What's the general feedback been from scouts? Like what things did they say? What attributes do you bring to the table that are most impressive to them? Are there – sorry.
Huh? All right, I'm coming. That's my dad.
Yeah.
just my routes, my hands, my quickness, my speed. I bring a lot of stuff to the table. My special teams ability, be able to catch punts. I mean, that's a job in itself. And people take it for granted sometimes, but it's the possession of the ball. So, just getting a lot of good feedback, a lot of feedback that's very encouraging. A lot of meetings with GMs, a lot of meetings with position coaches, which is also very encouraging when you get in with personal people like that instead of scouts. It's very encouraging. So I'm excited about it. I'm excited about the 26th, and I'm excited about where I land, who picks me, and I'm excited about that phone call I'm going to get.